you out so late. Thanks for being here. I wanted to talk to you about Mari-san. It's strange how I couldn't remember Mari-san until now. Even when Hasegawa-san said her name, it didn't quite occur to me who she was. But the moment she called me Haru-chan, suddenly, it felt like a lid popped open to my mind. My memories came pouring out. I remembered all these things about my childhood. About Mari-san. How could I forget someone I loved so much? I think what happened with my father affected me more than I realized. All the times we spent together. And the moment he passed away, I must have suppressed those memories deep within my heart. At some point, I got used to hiding things away, and I even forgot a good friend like Mari-san. Thanks for understanding. To be honest, a long time ago, I remember tagging along with Mari-san and my father during a golfing trip. I was so happy running around that I ended up tripping and falling. And of course, I started crying. And that shocked me at first because I always thought of her as an extremely gentle person. But because I knew she was so kind, I managed to stop crying and eventually got back up. I remember thinking Mari-san would never say anything out of place. I trusted her completely. At that point, Mari-san hugged me and said, "No matter how many times you fall, you can always get back up and start again. Never forget that." Can you believe it? I didn't quite understand back then, but I think I do now. There's more to good character than kindness. Being good means dealing with the bad in front of you. It means to take a stand, even when all you want to do is run away. To realize nothing will change if you keep ignoring reality. I have you and the Phantom Thieves to thank for that. It's too late to save my father. But it's not too late for Mari-san. This time, I can change things around. I want to tell her exactly what she told me all those years ago. Yes. Thanks for hearing me out. Tomorrow, I'm going to do my absolute best. But for now, good night.
Hey. Why is Haru so upset over Mariko Hyodo? I don't have a heart, so it's hard to understand. Why do people try so hard for others? I wonder if I'll ever know. Okay. I'll believe you. It may seem like a simple concept to you, but to me, it makes my mind go... But I am humanity's companion. I am here to learn and grow.
Desires you stole this very night? This is...
You...
And they say they're going to steal my desires? What a bald-faced lie!
Those desires are mine, and mine alone! As long as I'm the monarch, I won't let anyone stop me!
Very well. I was just beginning to work up an appetite.
I wonder what you'll taste like. Perhaps I should gobble you up and find out!
Wait for us, Mari-san. It'll all be over soon. We need to change Mari-san's heart. Now that we're here, let's get going.
About the wait, we're here to kick ass and
silence.
Who the hell is she?
That couldn't be Mari-san. What on earth happened to her? I'm guessing this is Hyoda's distorted form.
What do you think of that? You and Beth. Oh, I'm almost there. Only a few more votes and I'll win re-election.
This is wrong, Mari-san. Those votes you gathered by twisting the people's hearts are worthless. And if you don't stop your tyranny, your staff will collapse one by one. I get why it's hard for you to trust people, but you still have to treat them with decency.
Ah! You shut your impudent mouth! I've done nothing wrong! I will wring out every ounce of corruption from my staff by working them into the ground. I'll silence all charlatans who betray me. I will consume every last vote in the city. Whether these people agree with me or not, only then can I build a safe haven, a radiant snow city that sparkles like winter. Thank you.
to him. When you take away someone's desire, you rob them of their agency, the ability to make their own decisions. So what good does it do to turn your loyal citizens into mindless drones? Isn't it better to let them arrive at their own conclusions? To follow their own hearts?
How dare you lecture me!
Good job, Muir. You tell her.
Mari-san, say goodbye to the countless desires you stole. Because Beauty Thief and the Phantom Thieves are about to take them back.
Honestly, they're all in my way. This is the last straw. You made me so very hungry. To have time and the main course. It's true.
Taking those desires back.
Shut your pretty little mouth. What would you know? I will consume all who oppose me, no matter who they are. You either eat or be eaten.
Oh, what's with all the food?
I want some.
Now's not the time to tuck your feet. Here it comes.
Much better.
We could use that.
There, this one. Go ahead.
Leave it to me. Using it.
before she starts moving.
You sicken me. On your knees.
Thank you. get to work.
Welcome to the Velvet Room. You wish to strengthen it? How much power will you add? This is what you...
Okay.
How much power will you add? This is what you choose.
Okay.
You wish to strengthen it? May luck be on your side.
worry about the wait. We're here to kick ass and...
What? Who the hell is...
What on earth happened to her? I'm guessing this is...
Honor tree. They're all in my way!
Marisan, what you're doing is wrong. So we'll be taking those desires back.
Shut your pretty little mouth! What would you know? I will consume all... You either eat or be eaten!
Oh, what's with all the food?
Let's go.
Now's not the time for suffering.
You're mine.
Here she comes.
You sicken me.
Grab it down. Fire.
What? Be purified.
Fire.
It's a strong one. Exploit its weakness to burn.
You sicken me.
Take it.
You sicken me!
Sure.
Fire!
Yeah. What's up, dude? come again.
Welcome. This is a popular product. Here you are. This is a popular product. Thank you very much. Come again.
Thank you.
Oh.
Meow. Is this what you'd like? Here you go. Is this what you'd like? Thank you. You made your choice? Thank you. Please come again.
Welcome to the Velvet Room. You wish to strengthen it? How much power will you add? This is what you've chosen?
Okay.
How much power will you add? May luck be on your side.
I'll just add this.
Seeing any shadows at the moment.
Thank you.
about the wait. We're here to kick ass and...
What?
Thank you.
You think I can stay? You think I
can stay?
You think I can stay? I'm so grateful. You think I can stay?
Who tried to set you up, even the girl who died in the accident. Each of these things grieved you, and in order to make a city where none of it could reoccur, you took action as you saw fit. Am I right?
As the mayor, I know very well that little girl's death was ultimately my fault.
But my staff betrayed me! All for their insatiable greed! I thought I could leave that awful position behind. Unfortunately, it wasn't as simple as that. Had I gone, I'd only be replaced by greedy scum. That's why I never stepped down. In this world, it's either eat or be eaten. And with circumstances so cruel, I decided I'd be the one doing the eating. Even if every last one of my votes were false, at least I could use them to make the world a better place. But if I was replaced as mayor, who would be there to honor that little girl's memory? An innocent girl lost her life, yet I could do nothing to stop the evil still afoot.
It's not too late to set this right. First, you must tell the people everything that happened. Then can you get a fresh start? But this time, on your own strength.
That would be impossible. I cooperated with those awful men to hide the truth. That way I could continue being mayor. There's nothing I can do.
Stand up, Mariko Hyodo! Are you just going to stay? You are a kind and strong woman, not someone who collapses over mistakes. So stand up and hold your head up high, because no matter how many times you fall, you can always get back up and start again.
Isn't that...
Yes. You said that to me a long time ago. Even if you told the people the truth about the incident, there are those who would still see the good in you. Don't let your position ruin you. Think back to what you stood for.
She's right, Mayor. You can't give up.
If you tell everyone your side of things, they'll listen.
When my father died, I felt like my heart was going to break. But thanks to the Phantom Thieves, I was able to stand strong and move forward. That's why I know you can too. Remember the part of you that taught me to get back up, no matter how many times I fall.
Yes. You're right. Thank you, Haruka. What I've done was wrong. I drove my employees to the brink and used a strange power to manipulate the votes. I was so driven by my personal agenda, I lost sight of how I originally felt. And why I ran for mayor in the first place. To make a city beloved by everyone. To give back to the home where I was raised. That's reason enough to take another step. I won't make this mistake again.
I never needed this power from the start!
Haru-chan, you've grown so much.
Your father must be so happy.
Mari-san.
Happy?
This place is collapsing! Let's go!
Alright, and that's that chapter there. I'm not sure exactly what's gonna happen after this, but we're gonna find out.
That took us quite a while.
Haru, you were fantastic. It was only because you were all with me. But I do wonder if Mari-san will be okay.
I'd say so. Her shadow disappeared like they always do.
Yeah, your feelings definitely reached her. I'm sure her heart has changed for the better. Well, I guess this wraps up the mission. We still need to confirm that the citizens are all back to normal. It'd be nice if we could do that right away.
Can we grab something to eat first? I'm hungry enough to pass out here.
He has a point. Battles can't be fought on an empty stomach.
The battle's already over, but still.
Hey, can we try Genghis Khan? That delicious lamb barbecue dish?
That's a must in Hokkaido.
I'm not sure.
What? I thought we were finally getting lobster hot pot.
Since when did we decide that? Why would we when it's so damn hot out?
But if you think about it, isn't Genghis Khan also sort of like hot pot? No way! Isn't it supposed to be barbecue?
Well, cooking Genghis Khan does require a utensil called the Genghis Khan pot. And you can't barbecue in a pot. Does refer to group.
Does it even matter?
Hey, was that a smile just now? Yeah, straight from Sapporo, it's Beauty Thief's award-winning smile.
I'm relieved too. I thought you might be weighed down by all that's happened.
Indeed. She was so weighed down that she met up with our leader for a private midnight chat.
Are you watching?
Sophia?
Sorry. Okay, I've got it.
Everyone seems pretty normal to me.
Their fanatical support for Mariko Hyodo appears to have died down.
I'm glad they're back to their senses. What a drastic change. Just goes to show how powerful a monarch's influence can be.
Hey, guess what? Hyodo-san's holding a press conference right now.
Thank you all for taking your time to gather here today. Actually, there's something I've been meaning to share with everyone. As of today, I will be resigning from office. I do not intend to seek re-election either. During my time as mayor, I've betrayed all of your trust. You may think of me as a mayor who's earned your trust, but in truth, there's plenty that I'm ashamed of. The snow sculpture that collapsed. It was built by an unscrupulous company that bribed one of my staff. In spite of my responsibility, I neglected to see the finer details and went ahead with the construction. As a result, the sculpture ended up collapsing, and the girl's precious life was lost. Furthermore, I elected to cover up the truth. All so I could save my position. I've been garnering votes I didn't deserve in order to stay on as mayor. I betrayed everyone to protect myself and covered it up by allowing more wrongdoing. I am among the guilty. That little girl, she died because of me. As such, I will have the police reinvestigate the case and offer my full assistance. And again, I will drop out of the election and forfeit my position as mayor.
Seems that Hyodo-san's made up her mind. I wonder if she'll be arrested. Good question.
Hyodo was afraid that if she wasn't the mayor,
she could have told the truth and made her underling take the blame. But she was concerned about other evils potentially lurking in the shadows.
I think this turned out for the best. Mari-san wouldn't have wanted to hide her mistake forever.
Zenkichi is on the line.
Hey, you guys see Hyodo's press conference? You all did a bang-up job. Really can't thank you enough. They plan on bringing Kyoto in as a key witness regarding the accident. I knew you'd want to analyze her phone, too. So I pulled a few strings. And now I'm her personal chauffeur. At least as far as the station. If you want, I can open up some time for you to talk to her. Just tell me where you want to meet.
I'm sorry. How could you ever forgive me, Kaho-chan?
Mari-san.
Haru-chan. Listen, there was something wrong with me. It's like I was in a terrible dream. I don't know when it was that my heart grew so cold. But after what you told me, I remembered who I really was inside. When I became mayor, I wanted to protect the city and everyone in it as if they were my own family. I remembered that feeling. Thanks to you, I've finally been able to confront myself, and I realized that I was doing a horrible disservice to that girl. I have lost sight of reality and begun acting self-righteous. Nothing I did was for her sake.
But Mari-san, you were doing the best you could.
No, it's the truth. Had I not realized my mistake, I would have likely continued to hurt even more people. But that's not what Kaho-chan would want. So let me say thank you, Haru-chan. Thank you for saving this city. For saving my family.
Mari-san!
Your father's recent passing must have caused you so much turmoil. I'm sorry I added to it. But if there's anything I can do for you in the future, any way I can be there, just ask me.
I say this because you're a precious part of my family, too.
Thank you so much, Mari-san.
Oh, Haru-chan!
I'm happy for you, Haru.
I suppose I must get going. Though I am concerned about the state of affairs I've left our city in, I'll leave it up to my successor. An arrogant wretch like me has no place being the mayor.
Does that mean you won't be involved in politics anymore?
Yes. I'm too ashamed to show my face in public. And at my age, there are plenty of younger folks who can...
Mayor.
You're...
I saw the news. So you're resigning. And you're leaving politics for good?
That's right. I've promised to step down and never... You can't be serious! Resigning won't bring her back. In fact, it won't change a thing.
Kaho.
Nothing can change what happened to my daughter.
Hey, shouldn't we get in there?
Hold that thought a moment.
So you can't. You can't just run away. You need to start over. Become our mayor again. What? When I was weeping with rage and grief, you stood there and cried with me. Instead of running away, you were there when I needed someone the most. I know your character more than anyone.
Ma'am.
Thank you for sharing your heart with me. Then I promise to both you and your daughter, I will stand back up and become your mayor again.
Mari-san. I don't get it. I know this is a sad moment. Everyone is crying, but it also feels warm and kind. How would you describe this? Kyoto to transform sadness into happiness, recording valuable data. Sophia has learned happiness.
That must have been the mom of the girl who passed away.
You know, it seems like she really understood Kyoto's intentions.
I'm so happy for you, Mari-san.
She reminded me of what Haru said in jail.
Stand up, Mariko Kyoto! Like that?
Hey! That was a tender moment! There's no need to reenact it.
Yeah, but you played it so cool back there. Ugh, it really touched my heart.
Could you please forget it already?
Indeed, truly moved.
You did get it.
That's...
It really was touching.
Nice.
Hmm.